will not be stagnant.
That's right.
Because when you're preparing for a race, there's a whole lot of things that you have to get ready to do. Amen?
Amen.
We said, on your mark, get set. Go means to move from one place to another, to travel, to leave, to depart from your current position. Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you to the Grace Olympics this morning. It's time to move forward as a team.
That's right.
As one body in
That's
Christ.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
In Joshua 1:7-9, it tells us to be strong,
That's
to be
right.
very courageous, and we shall have success wherever we go. We have to have good courage. Be not dismayed, knowing that God is with us wherever and wherever we shall trot our feet, we shall win.
That's
God
right.
has said it. He has declared it. We just have to believe and walk in it.
Come
Amen.
On. Amen.
When I think of a race, I think of the Olympics. I don't know why, but I do. Over 200 countries come together to compete. All around the world, athletes are preparing for July 2020. That is our next Olympic Games. And they're not preparing alone. They have a team. Somebody say team.
Team.
And when you think of Olympics, you think of overcoming odds. Anticipation, you have loss and you have victory. The Olympic motto is faster, higher, stronger.
Mm-hmm.
If we take that same mindset and put it into the church,
come on,
we'll be faster to pray than to gossip.
Come on. Come on.
We'll be faster to pray than sit up here and be denied.
Come
we'll be
on.
Faster to pick up our sisters and brothers versus pulling them down. We'll be faster to actually go on our knees for our church and our pastor and our, for our first family, because it is something that we have our mindset of Christ.
That's right.
It also, once you get into position and prepare, it takes you to higher elevation.
Mm.
That higher elevation is the double anointing. That higher elevation, you see things differently. You think things differently because you have the mindset and the love and the voice of Christ. We all have made mistakes, but the more that we spend time with Christ, the more we find ourselves in position because we're prepared to go.
That's right.
If we take stronger, that means that we as a body of Christ can come together and unite, and we are a stronger body that people can come in and they are healed. People can come in, they are loved. People can come in and they feel the Spirit of God.
Amen.
If you are in position.
Come on.
If we apply that to our church, ask your neighbor, say neighbor. Whose team are you on?
Whose team you on?
Say neighbor.
Neighbor.
And who's on your team?
And who's on your team?
We as a body of Christ should be one. We are Christian Olympians that should be able to reach out not just the city of Grace, but every neighborhood in greater Central Florida, of Orlando, throughout the country, as the first lady just said. It is something that when you prepare, when we pray together, when we worship together, when you unite as one, there is nothing that can be defeated, because we always will win if we go back to the Word of God. Amen.
Amen.
As I read further into the Olympics, I find that 3 out of 4 are individual sports.
Mm-hmm.
With those individual sports, guess what? You have 2nd, 3rd, and 4th returning Olympians to come back, right? That's the part when they come back. The thing of it is, they ask them, what is the secret to your success? Whether you are playing ping pong, whether you are running the race, they all seem to get bigger and better and faster and stronger. With that, the secret, they said, is team.
Come on.
T-E-A-M.
That's right.
Team. I said M. The team spirit is something that we have to have in unity of the body of Christ.
Come on.
In my prayer closet this morning, God did say who was going to be here, because this is the team.
That's right.
No weapon formed against this team shall prosper, because we are being obedient, because we are in preparation, because we're coming together, setting aside personal differences, setting aside our own opinion, and going after the mindset and the model of this church, of this leader. Because once you get into position and you prepare accordingly, that team is going to be the one that's going to help you sit there and pray through those situations. That team is going to be the one that's going to help you to come forth and be the woman in the God, that a woman and man of God that He has called you to be. A lot of times we feel as though we have that spirit. I don't need nobody else. The devil is a lie.
Come on.
Even Jesus came to earth. And guess what he did? He put together a team of 12.
That's right. That's right.
That team, some fall off, fell off.
Come on.
Some people did right and some people did wrong, but that was their purpose.
That's
when she said, sit here and look and be focused on your lane. At the end of the day, God has called each and every one of us with a purpose. And your purpose and position in this church.
Come on.
But we cannot be stagnant. We cannot become complacent. We cannot become weary, as we all have before. Because once you keep your eyes on the mindset of Christ, we know that everything he has already brought us through. Your eyes cannot even see. Your vision cannot imagine the territories, the land, the people that he has called you to minister to.
Yes, Lord.
And City of Grace, it's time to unite as one. Y'all say unite.
Unite.
It's time to come together as a body and take over this city. In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
If you're a magician, we're going to call upon the most anointed ones. If you're a praise team leader, we're going to be the most anointed in Central Florida. If you are a minister, we're going to keep on working on our craft. We're going to keep on putting our nose. God, keep calling us out.
That's right.
Because it's preparing us, not just for us, but the people that are coming through that door. When you on go, guess what? You can love those that don't understand love. When you on go, you can come together and unite. When you on go, we can stand together, we can fast and make change happen.
Come on.
It is our purpose, it's our destiny. We have not all gone through something for nothing.
That's right.
God got more sense than all of us.
That's right.
Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 11. I returned and saw under the sun that the race is not to the swift, nor the battle to the strong, nor yet bread to the wise, yet riches to men of understanding, yet the favor of men of skill, but time and chance happen to them all. As I get on my first closing, I was reminded of the ice bucket challenge. In the ice bucket challenge, then what they did was they took all this ice, they put it in the water. And they had two teams. Y'all say two teams.
Two teams.
Those two teams had it to where they would time you to see exactly, Tico, how long you could stand in this cold ice water. They timed it. First team, all right. Second team. First team, one person, one person, one person. It was time for the second team to take that challenge. The second team did it a little bit different, Robert. Y'all say a little bit different.
Different.
In grace, we have to think a little bit different.
Come on.
When you on go, it's not what you knew, it's what you now know. A lot of times we go and act off of things that have happened in the past. But it's time now that we change our mindset.
That's
now
right.
That we are preparing ourselves. What are we reading our words together? We're reading the word together. We're praying together. We're coming together. We're encouraging one another. Y'all say the second team.
The second team.
The second team did it a little bit different. Instead of one person then getting into the ice water, they brought up two people. One person was in the ice, and the second person was their cheerleader.
Come on. That's
statistics
right.
Showed that 50%, y'all say 50%, their time doubled by 50% because that second person was that person that was encouraging them. That person next to them was that person to tell them they can keep going. Because at the end of the day, it takes us to encourage us. It takes us to stay dedicated.
Come on.
It takes us praying for one another because we all are human and we do get weary. Amen. So look at your neighbor, say, who's on your team?
Who's on your team?
Say, who's on your team?
Who's on your team?
On go. Nike has the best model when he said, just do it. No excuses. Let's move forward as a unit and finish this race. Let's win the race together in unity, winning souls, encouraging one another, praying for one another, checking on one another.
Come on.
When is the last time we had somebody that hasn't been to church and you haven't even inboxed them or text them if you don't have their phone number? Everybody has Facebook and Instagram.
Yeah.
It's not even to come to church, but this just check. It's the little things in life that goes a far, far away with people. That's love and reach out a little bit more. Amen?
Amen.
Now look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
We have reset.
We have
reset.
We have prepared.
We are in position. Says now it's time to run.
Now it's time.
Say, neighbor, it's time to run.
It's time
to pass the baton that's going around this thing. Church hurt, that's all right. We're still gonna run. When we got to disappointment, that's all right. We're still gonna run. Guess what? We had an argument. We still gonna run. It is time to get on go. It is time now to stop with the excuses, because that's what the devil give us.
Come on.
And sometimes it ain't the devil, it's us, because we get in our feelings. Yes, we do. But it's time now to press go. It is time now to actually say, you know what, sister? Let's go, Lynn. Let's go, Tika. Let's go, Morticia. Let's go, Rohan. Let's go, Tico. Because it is now time for go.
That's right.
God is calling his people, and we are ready to run the race. How many of y'all come here tonight, today, to run the race? How many of y'all said, no matter what, God, I say yes. No matter what, God, we're ready to go. No matter what, God, it doesn't matter whether it's 2 or 10, we're gone, 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 gone. It don't matter, Lord, if I'm tired, I'm still come to Mega Monday. If it don't matter, Lord, if I got a headache, I'm still gonna come and worship. I'm still gonna come and praise. I'm still gonna magnify your name, because it is time to go. We got runners in here, y'all. Some of us out of shape, but we about to get it right. Amen. Amen. Do we have any runners in here?
Yes.
Do we have any runners in here?
Out of shape,
come on.
Yes.
Auxiliaries, come forth. Intercessory team,
yes.
Come forth. Anointed, come forth. Love, come forth. Unity, come forth. And today, do you all accept the challenge to be runners of grace?
Yes.
To be runners of the Lord.
Yes.
It's not just about the city of grace. She said it right when she said it's about reaching nations.
That's right.
It's not the people that's in the church. It's the people that haven't been to church.
That's right.
It's some people that's been church. It's some people that gave up on God. But we are here to win the souls. We are here to encourage those that are have a walk in Christ. Amen.
Amen.
And last but not least, it's not just about the unity of us. It's about reaching out to our families and keeping our first family in prayer.
Amen.
It starts with the head. But guess what? We still have to hold his hands up. Amen.
Amen.
So, City of Grace, I challenge you all to come together. I challenge you all to pass the baton. And if you see a sister or brother that might be just a little wounded, if you see somebody might have twisted their ankle or a knee might hurt, let's bring them along, because guess what? Every step that we make forward is another step for somebody to come forward. Amen?
Amen.
Today is the day of change, and I say, City of Grace, on your mark, get set, go! Go ye therefore and teach all nations. Go and baptize them in his name. Go out and get your anointing. Go out and win your family. Go out and pull them through. Run through, God. We thank you, God, in advance. And as we lift our hands, Lord God, we say thank you for the spirit of excellence. We say thank you for the spirit of anointing. We say thank you, Lord God, for the spirit that you have put in us and our purpose. And we drive to put on go in the City of Grace. Can you put your hands together all over this building? God bless you.